Welcome to week six. We've spent the last couple of weeks becoming really familiar with matrices and vectors, and in particular becoming comfortable with slicing and dicing matrices and vectors, thinking of matrices as columns, as rows, as submatrices, etc. The material that we're going to look at now is where a typical linear algebra course starts. We will be talking about how to solve linear equations. What I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through several different ways of looking at the same problem, and the purpose of that is to arrive at a practical algorithm with which to compute the solution of linear systems. Let's motivate the topic of solving linear systems of equations by looking at a situation that you may have encountered in week two in one of the homework problems. So here was a problem where you were asked to evaluate L for the vector 2, 3, and you were given how the two unit basis vectors were transformed. Now, by now you know that you can actually identify the matrix that represents the linear transformation, and therefore you should be able to simply do a matrix vector multiplication to come up with the answer. In particular, what you would do is you would say, well, I know that the first column of the matrix has to be 3, 5, and the second column has to be 2, minus 1, and therefore all I need to do is multiply that times 2, 3, and when I do that, I get my answer. However, at the time when you were asked to do this, you didn't know that yet. And let's look at a different way in which you might have been able to solve this. You can identify the linear combination, and then you can apply what you know to get the final answer. All right, so that one was a particularly easy one because it involved the vectors 1, 0, and 0, 1, and therefore identifying what this linear combination was easy. So now let's look at a more systematic way of identifying what those coefficients should be. We can give them a name, chi0 and chi1. We can then look at this, switch things around, multiply out, and identify two linear equations in two unknowns. And of course, solving this is particularly easy because you can just read off that chi1 is equal to 3 and chi0 is equal to 2. So that problem is very easy to solve. Let's go to a slightly more complex problem and let's follow the exact same steps. Okay, so the way you were supposed to solve this back in week 2 was to identify that the vector minus 1, 2 was just this linear combination of the vectors 1, 0, and 1, 1. And notice that this is a little bit more difficult to identify. And then again, you could have just put that into your linear equation and figured out what the solution was. How could we have done this in a more systematic way? We could have asked ourselves the question, what are those coefficients? We could have given those names, chi0 and chi1. And then again, we could have progressed towards a system of linear equations. And in this particular case, the system of linear equations is an upper triangular system of linear equations. And almost surely you have seen this somewhere before. And what you notice is that you can identify what chi1 is. It's equal to 2. And then you can replace this by 2 and figure out what chi0 is. And indeed, chi0 now is minus 3. And then you know that this should be minus 3. And chi1 should be 2, and you have your linear combination of the vectors 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay, well, let's look at one where it's a little bit more complex. Okay, so what if we are given two vectors, the vector 1, 2, and 1, 3, and we're asked the question how to create the linear combination of those two vectors that equals the vector minus 1, 0. Well, again, we can set this up to get two linear equations in two unknowns, which would end up like this. Now, there are lots of different ways to solve this system of two linear equations in two unknowns. And let's do it first the hard way. And the hard way is to say, well, we'll start with this linear equation. We'll solve it for chi 1. Notice that chi 1 would be equal to minus 2 chi 0 divided by 3. And then you could take that and substitute it in for chi 1, in which case you get the equation chi 0 minus 2 times chi 0 divided by 3 is equal to minus 1. And then you can go and actually solve for chi 0 by doing some algebra. And then finally, you can take that chi 0 and plug it into the second equation and solve for chi 1. Now, a couple of observations. Number one, if there were three equations in three unknowns, this would already get somewhat complex. If there were five equations in five unknowns, you would start pulling out your hair. Now, what we of course are interested in is a way of programming this up so that the computer does all the work for us. And you can imagine that manipulating all of these equations in this way would create quite a headache. So what we want to do is come up with a different, more systematic way of solving systems of linear equations. One way to do that is to recognize that we can do something called row elimination, sometimes called Gaussian elimination, sometimes simply called elimination. And what one does is recognize that one can take the first equation, multiply it by 2, and subtract it off of the second equation. So what do you get then? Then you get the new system of linear equations, chi 0 plus chi 1 is equal to minus 1. And the second equation becomes, let's see, we take 2 times this and subtract it off of the second equation that eliminates this term right here. 2 times this subtracted off of that gives us chi 1 is equal to 2 times that subtracted off of the 2 times the minus 1 subtracted off of the 0 gives us 2. And if I did everything right, then we would get that the solution is chi 1 equal to 2. And then we do chi 0 plus 2 is equal to minus 1. And that implies that chi 0 is equal to minus 3. So the solution vector is minus 3, 2. And if you're diligent about it, you then plug it back into the original equation. So if we get minus 3 plus 2, that's indeed minus 1. And 2 times minus 3 is minus 6. Plus 3 times 2 is indeed 0. So we indeed have the right solution here. What we're going to see is that we can either think of this as two equations in two unknowns, or we can recognize what's to the left of the equal signs as a matrix vector multiply, so that we have a matrix of the coefficients in the linear system, and then we have the vector chi 0, chi 1, and then this we call the right-hand side vector. Or we can think of it as what we call an appended system, and what that is will become clear in one of this week's videos. So, what do we see this week? Well, we will focus on solving systems of linear equations. We're going to see how to represent such systems of linear equations as appended matrices. We're going to be reducing matrices to row echelon form or upper triangular form. We will see how this leads to an operation known as an LU factorization.